They are, as we speak, advancing north across the Russian border in a move by coalition command that can only be considered as either gutsy.
Oh, God! Oh, no, God damn it.
Incoming!
What?
Run!
What is it?
Tactical nukes, God damn it! Cover! Get into the tank!
EMPs? Catastrophic destruction. All of that is bad. All of it.
Holy crap! There's nukes!
Kratos, the front of your tank column has been hit with a tactical nuclear strike. 90% casualties evident. Readings indicate enemy armored units bearing down on your location. Compose your squadron and move up range to destroy the enemy armor.
No high ground to grab on this one.
We split up into three columns and advance on the Red Star position. We'll be heading up a rocky corridor in the middle of the plain. We need to find the source of those tactical strikes. Man, we've got a visual on enemy units. Roger that, Sergeant. Give them hell. We own them.
Take too many more of these fucking hits. Rear armor, man, I could barely survive any fucking hits of my own.
You'll need to stay in your tanks for protection.
Long ago, during the First Age, a series of dark spells were created. One of these spells had the power to breach our world and the one of darkness. Spell with no purpose but that of destruction. Before it could be invoked, stolen and broken into six separate parts, six lines, six incantations. The spell, however, was dark and powerful and not easily destroyed. So instead it was hidden away in a place where none would find it, scattered about the world in six separate locations. Six different families entrusted with its safekeeping. But men are mortal, and time can be the enemy of fear. All too soon we forget how the bee will sting and the fire will burn. As time passed, the families forgot what these marks were for. Mankind dismissed the ancient warnings about these words of power. They were merely stories, tales from a long past time. But the denizens of the world of darkness knew nothing of time. With infinite patience they waited. Then, after a millennia, to their dark joy, the spells were rediscovered.
Welcome, everyone, all my friends and fans from around the world, in our brand new animated series, being shown only on Tuesday's Tales to Astonish, a series upon which we take these little one-shots of these doubles, and that may not have gotten a lot of light and a lot of love from the gaming community, but were phenomenal, phenomenal stories nonetheless. Something that definitely needs to be showcased in its own little series that we do on Tuesday's Tales to Astonish. This beautiful gem is called Frontlines Fuel of War. It used to boast the biggest multiplayer maps you've ever seen in matchups. But we're right now, we're going to get into the single player campaign. We're going to do it on normal. And we're going to get into this story. It's going to introduce you to what's going on and why and so forth. I am, of course, your host for the most, Rage of Crixus, coming at you like Cleopatra, monitoring his audio on his live Twitch stream so fans can either join in the game, join in the chats, and go from there. And obviously tell me secrets, something that you know, ask questions about the game. So we'll get into the intro and then we'll figure it out from there.
We've known it for a long time. The West knew it.
Serious problem. America is addicted to oil. It's inconceivable to me that our children will be able to maintain the American way of life and that the world won't be full of resource-based wars of all kinds.
The East knew it.
Successfully completed, it will provide for a significant increase in the volume of oil supplies from Russia to China.
We've known it for a century.
There is no doubt about our absolute and complete dependence on oil. Without oil, civilization as we know it could not exist.
Oil was running out. It's what we grew up in. Post-Middle East, post-peak oil, post-everything. What they called the long emergency. It started slow. Little things at first. Lines at the pump. That hot summer of 2008, when the blackouts started lasting weeks. The avian influenza hit in 09. I got taken out of school when there wasn't enough vaccine. They said it would get better. Something would save us. Biofuels, solar power, cleaner nuke plants, maybe. The depression hit in 2012. Africa ran out of food, then we did too. People stopped trying to do anything about the problems and just tried to survive. We'd watched them starve for 40 years and it didn't seem real. But pretty soon the scenes we used to watch on the news were happening just down the street. It's been happening for years. Now we're at the tipping point. I was 16 when the Chinese and the Russians figured out they'd rather fight us than each other. We didn't waste time forming the coalition. Now, we're staring each other down across the last wells in the Caspian. I left school for the Affiliated Press and they sent me overseas. Out here in Turkmenistan, you can see it clearer. In little prefab towns, the oil boom left in Central Asia. This is where it's going to happen. In towns too small to have a name, built in 2 weeks by oil industry contractors. It's 2024, the 21st century. People ask, what happened? I tell them, we always knew. The storm is coming.
Tone and a familiar story that seems to be playing out in our very real lives right now. This story takes place in 2024, which is obviously in a few weeks.
You'll be relieving Alpha Company of their refinery patrol duty.
A somber tone.
Temporary. Sandstorms in the area have knocked out radio communications and have been interfering with our satellite coverage. Once you touch down, find a working radio frequency and get Alpha Company to give me a status report. Oh, and show some respect to the embedded reporter along for the ride. The Coalition wants folks back home to know we're taking care of their energy needs. Try not to get too bored in that town, gentlemen. You'll be out of there in a couple of weeks. Command out.
Let's get into this Tuesday's Tales to Astonish. And see if it doesn't leave you a humbled feeling in your very pit of your stomach.
Skipper, but I'm still waiting for my in-flight meal.
Oh, dumbass.
So, you guys just rotating in?
Ah, you must be the local paparazzi.
Wise up, Braley. Yeah, we're coming off disaster relief in Anchorage.
We're being brought in to patrol the coalition's oil fields. Staff Sergeant Whitburn, Delta Chalk Leader.
Andrews, Affiliated Press. I'm doing a piece on all the military deployments to the Caspian. Gonna make you guys heroes.
Too late for that, Pops. I was born a hero.
Huh. A hero assigned to guard duty. Interesting.
Coming up on the pipe. Welcome to summer camp, boys.
You kidding me? They said the word
summer
was a
camp,
town.
He says.
More like a mining
hilarious.
Camp.
Hilarious.
It's a dump.
A pretty valuable dump, then. Both of the world's main oil is 100 miles from here.
Is that so, Princeton? Well, then why don't...
Well, he's dead.
We just lost the tail rudder!
Sergeant's hit!
Second fire!
Put your head down, Braley!
We're losing him!
Captain, get out of here now!
Incoming!
We're going down! Black Hawk down! Black Hawk down! And that, dear fans, is how you start an amazing season.
We've got
guns! Oh, shit!
Hey, are those miniguns still operational?
Right, right. Reassert control.
I have two bots to identify. I am posting them here, bud. Proceed to these objectives at your discretion.
Loading barrel. Or not. Which weapon?
Roger.
grenade launcher. Go like this. We're gonna blast all three of these sons of bitches right now. There's three in there. Right. That'll mess up your face. Hey, loves it. All right, you with the sniper rifle. Why don't you go put one in his pumpkin?
Okay. Sounds good.
You didn't bring me here for my good looks. All right. Dug in there like a bunch of Alabama dicks. Got a lot of realistic fucking elements to it right there. It really looks a lot like our actual life. Wouldn't you say? Well, let's go get him. Bullets! Demo charge. Boop!
space is now clear. Excellent work, stray dogs.
Okay, so now I gotta go to the other objective. Bet you fuckers had a bad time. Firing a hole. Been a minute since I played this game, fans. Been a minute. Gotta find a way inside this goddamn building. Here we go. Ooh, ammo. Sounds good. Sounds good. Fuck, we get in here. Well, I gotta blow that door. Maybe I gotta blow that door.
Repositioning, very clear.
Okay, I'm gonna fucking throw a grenade there. See if I can't blow that. Nope, that didn't work. How the hell do you do that? Man, I'm in. Reload. Get three weapons now. Even better.
Armory secure. Good work. Use the additional weapons.
All right, team.
Good work. Now you've got two heavily armed guard towers at the motor pool covering the road into the refinery area. I'm displaying them on your HUD. You've got to take them out.
Where do you want me to
get that road open? Once you do, check the garage for light armor.
Enemy spotted. Let's move on.
Check the garage, he says. Alright. Why don't you give me a task? That's hard to do. Alright. Got bullets. Shit. Shit!
Enemy infantry! Take cover! Goddamn, shoot him! Enemy vehicle spotted!
Take care of you! RPG. Gotta love it.
Pay attention to your order. Let's go.
Come on, get out of the open.
Good.
lower altitude reason. Love it! Come on, boys, let's get in.
Gates are open. Let's take out that motorcycle. They've got this area covered. Get an assault drone on the ground.
Let's move out. Enemy empty on the left. Yeah, there he is. Let's
you saw on Ghost Recon Wildlands, a film from Sunday Funday, using an adventure. I was using the drone a whole bunch. Oh, so I gotta get in there and actually kill him. I can't just get a drone strike. Boo! Okay. Well, let's go soften him up. As you can see, there's all kinds of turrets and shit. I don't want to deal with it. So that kills them. The whole box full of drones. Who doesn't love that?
Who doesn't love that?
Look at that. Three of them in one shot. Still got some guys with turrets in there. Alright, well, we'll take care of that. That's right. Clump together. I love it. I love it. But you guys were, like, smart.
Enemies, hold up behind that machinery!
Is turret still alive? Oh yeah, there's a guy up there still rocking turrets. Do you want to clump together? I love it. Okay, so I'm gonna pick up the drone, but I'm not gonna use it. We're gonna switch weapons. Come on! Go. Ooh, look at that. There's one of these drones. These drones are really fun. These are tank drones. These guys are a real. Why endanger the lives of good soldiers when you can just send in these drones, which can do a phenomenal job? Am I right? Who are you guys shooting at?
Who are you shooting at?
How far in? Can you go upstairs?
No,
we can't. Okay, let's go back to our soul. Come on. So I use these drones to soften these guys up. Pretty goddamn good. Get up here now with our boots. We'll get in there and hand-to-hand this shit. Everyone looks fucking dead to me. Hey?
tower secure.
This tower is ours.
Right on. We are picking up enemy infantry heading for your position. Prepare to defend yourself.
Good. That right. Let's go get all these positions first. Then we'll figure out how we're gonna do all that.
Come on.
start a targeting device to call in airstrikes.
Thank you.
Double time. Let's go, let's go.
There's our pickup, let's go.
Come on, get us out of here.
Hey, it's Andrew, hold on, we got
more. Man, is that some crazy action for our first episode or what? Awesome stuff.
All right, we're off there.
You wouldn't believe it. Got a feed from Caspian Central Relay. Red Star's pouring over the Turkmenistan border.
What? This is supposed to be a treaty.
Think about it. Blackouts, starvation, disease, economies are nearly collapsed. The Caspian and all its oil, it's been a powder keg just waiting to blow.
This World War III, Princeton?
Man, that's some dark shit. Dark, dark shit. Kind of what's happening in Ukraine right now, eh?
That's how it started. Was it World War III? We didn't know. But one thing we all knew, Red Star forces had hit hard. Nearly all of the coalition forces stationed in Turkmenistan were gone. At this point, the coalition began their first offensives of the war. The troops were ready, yet Red Star forces seemed to be everywhere. The fighting to claim energy assets all around the Caspian was brutal. But the biggest news was that the Chinese had invaded Taiwan. Things were really getting out of hand. As for the stray dogs, well, they were moving north now. They were about to unleash some inspired vengeance of their own. Sergeant Thompson always made sure of that.
Sergeant Thompson! Sergeant Thompson.
Better us than them. That's what I think. Lights, nothing from hydrogen,
nothing from fusion. Thought there was supposed to be something to get the shit done.
Listen,
right.
Listen, Finch, all I know is that shit didn't pan out. Now my family has to eat from a bread line.
Sergeant Thompson, we're on approach.
All right, men, listen close. And for those of you who haven't yet had the pleasure of my command, listen close. Straight dogs have been taking some shit lately. First we get drowned in Alaska, then Red Star ambushes our asses in goddamn Turkmenistan. Well, now it's our turn to go on the offensive, to make the Red Star wish they stayed the hell home!
Hell yeah, sir!
Because we are stray dogs! We can take it, and we can dish it up! That's what I want to hear! Once we're on the ground, command will be patching in with the final mission detail. Rack your gear, and get ready to deploy.
Their flag. The problem with everyone getting inside the Warthog is when they take out the Warthog, that's the three deaths. Remember, you only get so many lives. That's just how they're going. Pow!
Triple kill.
Go! Over there. Good job. Look out! trying to do to them? Bonnet.
Thompson, we've identified two ammo depots that the Red Star are using to rearm. I need your squad to capture those depots.
I'm on it.
You're the man, boy. Ammo depot secure.
Securing ammo depot. Good stuff. Now we gotta try and get some of this other stuff. Now that I got a rocket, that'll be a whole lot easier to do. Bow! Got him.
I'm ready for more.
What do you see? That's a whole fucking tower, eh? Oh, I got something. Let's try something. Yeah, they didn't like that one bit. Right. So that takes out that fucking thing. Honey.
Grenade!
Hit!
repositioning.
We're all done here. Let's move out.
Dead.
All right, let's get to that next objective.
Good, good.
Good work, stray dogs. Our boys in R&D will make good use of that information.
Ooh, a drone.
Let's get to the next objective.
These are fun. I got an idea. Let's go have us some fun. Since they're holed up in that building, maybe what we should do is use this here drone to ride over there and drive up and shoot them. Get out of the fucking way, rookie!
Area clear!
Okay, I guess I can really only go forward, eh? Yeah, so let's just drive this thing in there and blow them up. Shit. Yo, why is this so fucking difficult to operate? Come on, get into the building. So that kills you. Come on, let's go save the other two for another objective. Let's go. Now that they're all softened up. You know what the problem was? It could have been hard to control because the signal strength was a little shitty. Right? Because you saw that down on the lower bar, right? So maybe I'll have better control with me being a little bit closer. Right? Now remember, this is an old game, at least 10 years old. At least, probably even 15, if not more. This thing is definitely fucking hard. Okay. Let's go. Come on.
We're all down here. Let's move out.
Oh, you get them both? Oh, shit.
Upgrade the gun.
What's up, fucker?
Area clear.
Our reinforcements are on their way.
armor reinforcement. That would fucking be ideal, wouldn't you think? Right. Always want to attack. Like a glove. Let's go take this wooden bridge. See if it can hold the weight of this tank. Got those Red Star binoculars, so maybe I'll use them. Oh, I can't call them in from here. That's moment there, fans. Take a moment. Take a look outside the window. Take a look at the world that you live in and what you want to do with it and where you want to go with it. Learn some skills. Life ain't over until you've breathed your last. You still got breath in your body. You can change your life and do all kinds of things with it. Just look at this. Look at this. We got the Predator mission got taken away from us, but we still got to keep the gear. And I got to film a whole TV series for the fans with all this cool gear on anyway. Just because we were the best fans of all. Look at that. If that doesn't make you appreciate the moment, appreciate your life, I don't know what will. Rock TV. daily inspiration. Click clack, that's worth a picture right there. I'll put that shit on a coffee mug. That wasn't so tough. So this series should take us about 3, maybe 4 episodes, depending how many times I screw up. We'll see how that happens. But as you can see, I'm motoring along at a pretty decent fucking pace rate.
There are 3 gates in and out of the factory compound. Before we assault the factories, we need to control at least 1 gate. Stay sharp now. They know we want this one.
Right. So, let's go take a really big tank. A really big tank. This is one of their heavy tanks. This one packs a fucking wall up. Still remembering how to play this game. It doesn't play as smoothly as a lot of the other games I've played, but because this is an older game, definitely an older game. Switch positions. What is this? Oh, so I can switch to machine gun or the main turret. Okay, so driver or assault. Dead bodies in there.
Hold up.
Lots of tanks.
Secure one of the entrance gates before moving on to the factories. Turn back.
Okay, I'm on it.
Factory and destroy the Redstone's manufacturing capability. The objective should be below, in the maintenance corridor.
Another.
the fucking hard way. Move it! Those drones, they sure do make it a lot more fun. Oh, there's all kinds of fun. Three guys down, come on! Advance!
Blueprints show the objective to be up above, on the catwalks. Watch your heads, boys, they're on the catwalk!
How do I get to those catwalks? Other side.
There's an AT soldier!
This is, of course, Tuesday's Tales to Astonish, only on Ruck TV Presents, bringing you the most retro gaming animated series you've probably ever heard of.
Hell yeah.
Don't pack your things yet. You don't get the news I do. Fighting spread to the Korean borders and the South China Seas. Last night, China took Taiwan. With China occupied on two fronts, Russia's getting desperate, reckless. Who knows what they're capable of?
China's took Taiwan.
How far you think this thing's
gonna
go?
Sounds like real life.
At the rate we're going, it's either Washington or Moscow. That was payback. A major Red Star tank factory, not simply destroyed, but even worse for the Red Star, captured. Because in an age of desperation that restricts every human endeavor, control of resources is ever precious. Which brings us to a very small and desperate recon mission, aimed deep behind enemy lines. The hope? To spark one of the early turning points of the war. It was David versus Goliath, an overambitious, impossible task. Yet no one would see it coming, especially not the Chinese.
The following contest is a fatal five-way tables, ladders, and chairs match. Making his way to the ring, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 215 pounds.
Focus 100.
Okay. Alternative check. AAD online. Equipment's good to go, Lieutenant. Now collect your weapons. Command will update your objectives once you're on the ground.
Stand by, Black. You are clear of the flatline.
Who's Jekistan? Right. Like it, sniper rifle.
Black AO, this is Command. Insertion on target. You are in the AO. We need you to recon the small mountain village ahead. Intel reports the Chinese use this mountain pass to send their tanks against us in Turkmenistan. Hostiles are unaware of your presence, but we've detected several enemy recon teams
now
on
that
patrol.
That ain't gonna stick right away for long.
They are marked by your HUD.
Guys down there. Lots of guys down there.
Confirm contact with enemy units. Terminate at your discretion.
Okay. Well, that all sounds well and good and all. So that fucking kills him. Oh, you want to get in mounted positions to take me on? Couldn't be more happy about that. Sure. Not really sure why that took so many shots. Should have hit him just fucking fine. Another block. That's a pretty good shot. Anybody? Chat lines are open. I'm filming this live on Twitch. If anybody can see what's what, I see you. And he doesn't see me. He ain't gonna see nobody no more. Okay, let's get close.
Thank you.
Nicely played, sir. Almost got me. What? Someone sees me. Whoa, there's a whole bunch of guys down here. There's a whole bunch of people. Right. Blow his fucking leg out. What? Maybe we should send in a fucking drone. Take out that damn turret. Hey! Let's go see if there's anybody down here. And there is. I really want to be using this guy to take out a fucking turret. Signal strength is really bad. Oh, there's a whole bunch of guys down here. Look at that. Okay. I'll go do this by foot. I get him? It's like I did. Ooh, look at that. He's got a tank. Like that even better.
Confirmed area clear. Forward guard post right. Secure.
Right. That's good. That's good. Bullets are good. Tajikistan. What? Got no fucking gun there now. look at who it is. Somebody's trying to get the drop on me. Trying being the term for it. Because it obviously did not work. Not a bad little game. Like I said, even just the campaign alone, even though it was a little short, it's good. But the multiplayer is just epic in scale. I only got a chance to play it a couple times.
Good work, Black Halo.
It was something
else. This first area is clear.
Ooh, shack under the fucking face.
A communications trailer and a third outpost up on the ridge. Eliminating these will allow you to approach the village undetected.
What else does that? One of these things. That blows the back of his fucking head off. Someone sees me. Whoa! Who the fuck can see me, man? Who can see me? Okay, I think what I gotta do is I gotta get to that fucking clock tower. I gotta get to that tower and find out who's sniping me. Yo, get up this rock piece. Right now. Really? So there's no way up there. Is that what you're trying to tell me, game? Your game physics is that fucking limited? Come on, you. If the computer can get up there, I can get up there. Well, apparently I'm fucking surrounded now. There was no one there before, and now I'm surrounded. Well, now I'm completely surrounded. I got no one on my map. Can't see nobody, but no, there's a fucking ton of people here. Comedy at its finest. Game wants to cheat to win, it's gonna fucking cheat to win. This is just how it goes. Come on, you! I'm so confused as to why this is impossible. Why is this impossible? Like, as I'm not allowed to do it? I'm up here. I did it!
All right, lads. I'll give you Blackbeard's honest opinion. You ask me, can this new captain promise you a life of prizes, plunder, and adventure? Aye. For amongst all the gentlemen of fortune sailing these West Indies, he ranks amongst the most clever. There was a time when I thought myself the deadliest scourge of these seas. But this man is a fearsome dog who feeds off trouble and turmoil. I seen him clear the deck of a Spanish galleon like it were nothing. fighting like a devil, dressed as a man. And he's a canny one. Knows his way round every crag and crevice of these islands. So if it's fortune and adventure you seek, then Captain Edward Kenway's your man. Only, don't meddle in his private affairs. For there's more mystery to that man than even I dare ask.
Now I gotta find out where I'm getting sniped. See, there's a really good shot out here somewhere. I see you. I see you just fine. Am I doing this by myself? Like, where the fuck are the rest of my units? All right. Stick to the high ground. Right in the fucking eyeball. See anybody else? Okay, let's go. That sniper not seen.
Roger that. Communications
fucking dead now. Come on. See his gun. Fucking eyeball. Sure that happened. Threw his fucking hat right up. Why don't you go in here and tell me what you see? One guy around the corner with a shotgun. So he's dead. Come on. Another tank. I like that. Like that a whole bunch. What a wonderful Tuesday's tales to Astonish.
Get back to the field of battle. We've still got work to do.
I'm on it. Just trying to get an elevated position, you goddamn bastard. Because I may have to stick to a field of battle, but the fucking AI does not, and so it likes to cheat you out ASAP. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking we throw in a goddamn tank drone.
There's an anti-aircraft site on the outskirts of town. Take it out and we'll drop you additional reinforcements.
Everybody looks dead. You see what I see? Sure you do. These inept guards don't seem to see me shooting them in the head. That's funny. Get him? Looked like he dropped just before the bullet went to him. Right, let's get the fuck out of here. In the field of battle.
Anti-aircraft battery neutralized. Reinforcements are en route to your position. Prepare for imminent arrival.
Good stuff. Tajikistan. Nice place to live. If you like being ruled by a dictatorship, which I hear kind of sucks. Takes away all my Oscars. Ooh.
These men are here to assist you in any way they can.
Roger that, Command. The stray dog deserves some assistance.
Clear to move into the village. It's occupied by a garrison of Red Star infantry and light vehicles. You have two objectives in the town. Garrison headquarters and the motor. You need to hold them both.
We got enemy behind those sandbags! Our copy!
Right, those are all headshots. I don't even know how they're missing. Guys. your fucking head out. Guys are good shots. Guys are damn good shots. Bunkered in there real well. God damn you. Targets on the field, and I'm the one they want to shoot at from across the map with an assault rifle. Pretty ballsy, I'll give you that. All right, let's go. Shots.
Going to new cover. Move it.
That's the garrison HQ. Use caution. Telemetry indicates a lot of Red Star activity inside.
Cover me! Enemy spotted!
Intel is reporting that Red Star troops are about a half mile out. a mix of infantry and light vehicles. They're only about a quarter click out.
Command, I have confirmed visual contact.
Roger that. We have no additional reinforcements in the area.
Do your best. Keep coming.
That fucking airstrike, let's fucking go. Took this back. You want to explain to me? Pinocchio.
fighting stray dogs.
People pursuing is dying!
Ooh, look what it is. With this goddamn gun. Is there somebody in here?
What are you passing these?
Area clear, no more red. Moving to cover.
Moving fire.
Let's move it on up. Next objective.
Come on, come on. Let's do it. Somebody, like, who the fuck do you see?
Let's move up.
Gotta love horde mode.
Satellite shows enemy forces as eliminated or dispersed. Congratulations, stray dogs. You just might have turned this war in our favor.
Woo-wee! Hoo-ah!
Confirming your report. All Red Star armor in the valley eliminated. This is an extraordinary victory for the Coalition, men. Our Southern armor companies will now be free to launch offensives of their own. Excellent work. Come on back in.
We were traversing the Badlands in Kazakhstan when Coalition Command made a gutsy call to send troops north, across the Russian border. This was the day I heard about the murderous rioting back home. Deaths. I grew tired of the years of red lines, water shortages, constant. It's a swarm of anarchy. Society had gotten so used to constant electricity that when it failed, the darkness drove people mad. You might think we'd start to adapt. Father read to me once. It said that without a structured society, human beings would return to savagery. Well, it seems that the author was right. Because society was crumbling all around us. And that day in the Kazakhstan Badlands, all the rules of engagement crumbled right along with it. They are, as we speak, advancing north across the Russian border. I'm here in the desert. By Coalition Command that can only be considered as either gutsy.
Oh, God! Oh, no, God damn it.
Incoming!
What?
Run!
What is it?
Tactical nukes, God damn it! Cover! Get into the tank!
EMPs? Catastrophic destruction. All of that is bad. All of it.
Holy crap! There's nukes!
It's radars. The front of your tank column has been hit with a tactical nuclear strike. 90% casualties evident. Readings indicate enemy armored units bearing down on your location. Compose your squadron and move up range to destroy the enemy armor.
No high ground to grab on this one.
We split up into three columns and advance on the Red Star position. We'll be heading up a rocky corridor in the middle of the plain. We need to find the source of those tactical strikes. Man, we've got a visual on enemy units. Roger that, Sergeant. Give them hell. We own them.
Take too many more of these fucking hits. Rear armor, man, I could barely survive any fucking hits of my own.
You'll need to stay in your tanks for protection.
I'm just shooting that guy. That guy took like four big hits and nothing destroyed that tank.
Yeah,
holy shit.
Hostile armor in my sights.
Things are not that easy to drive. Game mechanics behind this particular thing. Not so fucking shit hot.
Good contact, heavy armor.
I
positions ahead.
Hostile inbound.
sites that their artillery was using. It's an old Soviet cosmodrome to the northeast. They use a large space
cosmodrome
there. They'll need to advance through the hills towards that facility. There will be a gauntlet of resistance. They expect you to clear a path.
God damn. Clear, what the fuck you call that guy?
Put
Jesus Christ,
on.
It's a good thing I don't believe it.
Honestly.
Nothing here? Really? Just a tower full of shit. Oh, bullets. Ooh, and a rocket launcher. That's exactly what I needed. Good thing I went up here. OCD for me. Come on, let's go back in the tank. Incoming artillery, R.O.C is here to try and take me out. Got a turret. I was like, what the fuck is shooting? Man. Really? Did you really just shoot the side of the bunker instead? Holy shit, you fucking stink.
That's one massive problem taken care of.
Guys, but they're not actually shooting. You notice they're shooting any bullets? Because I fucking don't. It's like as if I'm the only one shooting bullets. Weird. Because it's not like they're holding water pistols. You know what I mean? Like as if I'm the only one shooting.
Enemy unit!
Heavy guns right ahead!
I see him! Go get him!
Right, so that takes care of that problem.
Fire!
tanks rolling in!
I see them! Knock them back!
Look out!
Right. Well, as much fun as that all is.
I was having a good day today.
We got contact with enemy armor.
Fucking more, you're not
ready. Contact with enemy armor.
Gotta stop trusting these guys. Okay, well, the guy's obviously taking a full clip and still fucking has enough gumption to fucking shoot. That's pretty good. That's pretty goddamn good. Good. good story. Okay, get back to what we were doing. Boy, that guy got his lucky shot on. Like I'm being shot.
Third group is dead, Command.
Don't worry, man.
What exactly is going on right now? You can see my screen, fans? What is going on? Like I said, this game's a little clunky. Got some holes. Oh, I like all of that. I like all of that a whole bunch. Tally ho!
Onward to battle, our heroes go. Straight up. Fighting for freedom. Freedom fighting for their lives.
Yeah, I swear to Christ, I'm the only guy shooting at anything. Demo charges up.
Good work, stray dogs.
A hell of a battle. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
Only on Tuesday's Tales to Astonish, and only on Rock TV Presents.
System at the base of the tower. Detonating this should ignite the fuel lines and destroy each of the rockets.
Well, you heard the man. Assholes and elbows. Let's go.
The Red Star are using an EMP generator. It will disable any vehicles in its pulse radius.
I gotta get out. How much for that?
Guys, not so bad. Enemy unit.
Fire!
Right.
Red Star, on the right! Behind that deer, take him out!
Son of a bitch. Yeah, it definitely gets harder to control the farther you get away. That's for sure. There's the guy. Looking for him. Sure you did.
Pay attention to your orders. Let's go.
Hey. Well, we just cleared out a bunch of dudes, so that's all good. We'll find that ladder. Or just jump down like a tart. You could do that.
I got him in sight! Red Star on the right, behind the machinery. Take him out!
Yeah, why don't you do that while I do this? How about that? How about that?
First launch facility destroyed. Nice work, Stray Dogs.
Good
stuff. Stray Dogs, we have a problem. The fuel lines in the far launch tower didn't ignite. The rocket must have been disconnected and already fueled up. You'll need to get to that tower and place a charge up on the rocket itself. Move quickly.
Quickly, he says. Easy to do with a tank. We have a tank. We do have a tank. All right. Have tank. We'll travel. Let's go try this. Come on, advance forward. mean, it takes so long for it to switch commands. So long to switch commands. Fuck!
Like, duh!
Old games. That is the challenge with old games. Game mechanics just aren't quite up to snuff. The shadow of the helicopter, you would think it would be a little bit closer.
Hey,
forward.
Got one of them. What about? No, that's not. Just go in. Sniper rifle. Why did you just say so? Somebody on the left. Goddamn it, fucking no.
Right. Sure, I understand what that is. baby.
This area is secure. Red Star won't be using it to nuke anyone. Good work, men.
Good.
You faced
good,
and overcome unthinkable adversity. You've made us all very proud.
Cool. How awesome is that?
Like I said, Andrews, World War III, right?
Saddle up, men. We need to move. We're not out of this yet.
The Red Star Southern Russian headquarters was a base inside a mountain. The Russians' very own Cheyenne. The place had been around since the Cold War of the 80s, and they just kept upgrading it. Special intelligence reported that there was an ICBM nuke inside, capable of hitting coalition targets. The Russians had already proven they had the balls to use it. Red Star armies had also counterattacked in Kazakhstan, and mounted a major offensive in Eastern Europe, capturing sections of the Baltics and the Ukraine. The Russian general himself was thought to have been commanding from inside the base. And I guess the stray dogs really wanted to meet him, because they brought one hell of a greeting party.
Incoming!
Unbelievable. I thought they got rid of these things decades ago.
Yeah, that's just the outside. The actual fortress is deep underneath the mountain.
Yes, I understand, sir, but we'll need an additional 2 to 3 rounds of airstrikes. High altitude this time. We barely scratched
the surface. Not gonna happen. You're gonna have to take it by foot.
Yes, sir.
You hang in there, Sergeant.
Of course, sir. They've got an ICBM in there with a huge nuclear warhead on it. We have no choice but to go in and get it. So get to the tanks. Command will brief you momentarily.
And that, dear friends, is where we're going to end this awesome inaugural episode of Frontlines Fuel of War. I hope you're having a lot of fun watching it. It's definitely, like I said, it's an older game, but a very unique and cool story. Man, it looks like we're really plowing through it, too. But yeah, the storyline campaign doesn't take very long. We actually might get it done next episode, so who knows? It looks like we might. You guys were plowing through pretty good. So I hope you've been having a lot of fun watching it. This is, of course, Rage of Crixus on Ruck TV Presents on our Tuesday's Tales to Astonish, inviting you to join us for our next stream, which is going to be Thursday, actually. Normally, it would be Wednesday's Wide World of Wrestling, but we're actually going to shift that to Friday this week because I got to work 2 shifts tomorrow, 2 double jobs. And so we're going to do TNA Thursdays, Total Nonstop Action Thursdays. And we're going to be getting into the second episode of our awesome, episode of our awesome Assassin's Creed Chronicles trilogy takeover, and we're going to get into Assassin's Creed Chronicles Russia, a game I've actually never played because I only played a little bit of China, as I stated last Thursday, and I wasn't too impressed with it. But I'm glad I actually gave it a second chance because it's a lot funner than I thought it was. The gameplay for the video is still on Twitch. It'll also be released on YouTube on Thursday at 6:30. So you can see it all chopped up and edited because we took some stuff out that we thought was dragging it out. So TNA Thursdays, Total Nonstop Action Thursdays, will be our next stream. And it'll be on Assassin's Creed Chronicles Russia, a game we've never played. So it will be full of chock full of gamer tips and gamer insights and how we're going to get through this amazing, cool, artistic view that a Ubisoft did way back in the day. 2015, I think it was. So, I hope you had a really good time watching this one. Like I said, next Tuesday, if I don't have to work, we'll be continuing it a little long. I'm going to chop this one and edit it, and I'm going to throw it onto YouTube right away, probably today, as long as my computer holds out. It's been giving me kind of guffed the last couple days, so we'll see how that works out. So, don't forget, so TNA Thursdays, Friday's Wide World of Wrestling is going to take over for Wednesday's Wide World of Wrestling just for the week, where we're going to get into the rosters of Rock TV Presents and Raw is War. And I think we're going to debut another character as well, someone I've been anxiously trying to get my hands on and trying to get it going. So we'll see how that works.
And then we got our regular weekends full of stuff. So pay attention to the schedules. They change often. Our social links are all up on Twitch and YouTube, so you can stay up to date on its exclusive content that it gets, and also schedule changes, highlights, and so on and so forth. So, this is Rock TV Presents Rage of Pricks, signing off on another great broadcast.
Eyes open, Zeta.